Welcome to our gathering. We're glad that you have found us on this day. We give thanks for you who have joined us through YouTube. Your time with us serves as a powerful reminder that the body of Christ is one even when we are separated, as now. We pray God be with you as we set apart this time for scripture, song, and prayer. Bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise God in the firmament of his power. Praise God for his mighty acts. Praise God according to his excellent greatness. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Trinity, one God whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from generation to generation.
Amen.
Trusting in the mercy of God, let us confess our sin. Reconciling God, we confess that we do not trust your abundance, and we deny your presence in our lives. We place our hope in ourselves and rely on our own efforts. We fail to believe that you provide enough for all. We abuse your good creation for our own benefit. We fear difference and do not welcome others as you have welcomed us. We sin in thought, word, and deed. By your grace, forgive us. Through your love, renew us. And in your Spirit, lead us, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life. Amen. Beloved of God, by the radical abundance of divine mercy, we have peace with God through Christ Jesus, through whom we have obtained grace upon grace. Our sins are forgiven. Let us live now in hope, for hope does not disappoint, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you direct our lives by your grace, and your words of justice and mercy reshape the world. Mold us into a people who welcome your word and serve one another through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 10th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Anyone who welcomes you welcomes me, and anyone who welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. Whoever welcomes a prophet as a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever welcomes a righteous person as a righteous person will receive a righteous person's reward. And if anyone gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones who is my disciple, truly I tell you, that person will certainly not lose their reward. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 40, Jesus said, "Whoever welcomes you welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me." Jesus sent out his 12 followers. They are the hope that God is rebuilding the earth, the start of the kingdom of God. This is the beginning of the apostolic church, the messenger church. As, quote, "the church," unquote, our hope is that the world will one day embrace our witness. Looking again at Matthew 10, it is our hope that the world embraces not only our message, but the messengers. Saint Timothy, this congregation, we preach Christ. And will the world receive us and others like us? We associate gospel, that is good news, outreach, so often with professional preaching. Jesus' words in today's gospel point out how his disciples embody him. As Jesus says, "Receive in the name of." Translated, our place and time, simply the fact that people know you are Christian is a way for the world to make some kind of connection to God. Connect with God. Then that connection leads to welcoming. First, welcoming the disciples and their world. Second, welcoming the way as Christ is communicated today. Third, the world welcomes Christ by becoming a part of his church. Listen again to Jesus' word from the gospel. "Whoever welcomes you welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes he who sent me. Whoever welcomes the prophet in the name of a prophet will receive the prophet's reward. And whoever welcomes a righteous person in the name of a righteous person will receive the reward of the righteous. And whoever gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones in the name of a disciple, truly I tell you, none of these will lose their reward." This brand of welcoming named by Jesus is the act of joining with one another in a faith that shapes us in such a way that people meet Christ through us. Reflect for a moment how one might have come to faith in Jesus. Christ came through the biblical gospel conveyed by people who care, nourished in the Christian community. Not only do we receive Christ, we are inhabited by him. Really, received. "Whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me." Thanks be to God. Amen.
We confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Called into unity with one another and the whole creation, let us pray for our shared world. God of companionship, encourage our relationships with our siblings in Christ. Bless our conversations, shape our shared future, and give us hearts eager to join in a festal shout of praise. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of abundance, you make your creation thrive and grow to provide all that we need. Inspire us to care for our environment and be attuned to where the earth is crying out. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of mercy, your grace is poured out for all. Inspire authorities, judges, and politicians to act with compassion. Teach us to overcome fear with hope, meet hate with love, and welcome one another as you would welcome us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of care, accompany all who are in deepest need. Comfort those who are sick, lonely, or abandoned. Strengthen those who are in prison or awaiting trial. Renew the spirits of all who call upon you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of community, we give thanks for this congregation. Give us passion to embrace your mission and the vision to recognize where you are leading us. Teach us how to live more faithfully with each other. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of love, you gather in your embrace all who have died. Keep us steadfast in our faith and renew our trust in your promise. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hear these prayers, O God, and those too deep for words, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
O sacred King, O holy King, how can I honor you rightly? Honor that's fit for your name. O sacred friend, O holy friend, I don't take what you did lightly. Friendship instead of disgrace, for it's the mystery of the universe. You're the God of holiness, yet you welcome souls like me. And with the blessing of your Father's heart, you discipline the ones you love. There's kindness in your majesty, for it's the mystery of the universe. You're the God of holiness, yet you welcome souls like me. And with the blessing of your Father's heart, you discipline the ones you love. There's kindness in your majesty. Jesus,
peace, serve the Lord.